Hey everybody, Jeremy from AltRider, and we're going to do the installation in a series for the Africa Twin 1100. We're doing this installation on the Adventure Sports. Everything's the same for the standard model. We've got our universal brackets on in the front. We've got our lower assembly, lower crash bars installed. And now we're going to install our upper crash bars. And so with this, we receive the right and left side uppers, the upper crash bar bracket, which also of course works with your headlight guard. In the kit, you're gonna get four M5 flatheads for the connector, and then you'll receive two M8 by 40 through bolts that'll go through the subframe. And we still have our original hardware for the universal bracket, and this is what's gonna tie our lower assemblies with the lower part of the uppers and the lower crash bars into the universal bracket. Tools needed: M12 spanner, M13 spanner, M12 socket, an M13 socket, and an M4 Allen for my flathead out. So to start on our uppers, we're gonna go ahead and install the bracket. We need to take our two M8 subframe bolts out. So easiest way is the nut is on the rider's right hand side. So we'll start on the nut side with the socket and we'll hold it with the spanner. So go ahead and turn your handlebars all the way. It gives you access into here, and we'll lock onto that guy and we'll hold the spanner on this side. Save our nut. We're gonna reuse the OEM nuts and drive out the bolt, and we'll do the same for the second bolt on the subframe. Now I'm going to fish my upper bracket in place. I've got my thread locker and my two AltRider bolts to pass through, passing them this way, nuts on the other side. Here we go. So straighten the assembly out, and it'll slide right up and over, and it'll rest right there. And guys, we'll want to install both sets of bolts first before doing anything. And a little bit of wiggling will get that guy in. We'll get our upper. Okay. Now I've got my bolts in place, and what I'll want to do, because it's hard to get in there to get Loctite, I'll actually go ahead and Loctite directly into my nut. I'll get a couple drops in there as I get those guys started on my bolt, because it's hard to access in there. And here we go. So I'll turn the bar all the way. That gives me access from the back side to get the nuts on. There goes number one and number two. And then just in the same way I took those off, I'm now switching to a 12 millimeter socket, but now I need a 13 wrench on the bolt head side. All right. Now we've got our upper bracket in place. Rider's right hand crash bar, which is the one that has the insert. So this is where we get that additional strength. We don't collapse the bars here, guys. We get a tremendous amount of strength by sliding the inch diameter tube over this connector, and then it all locks into our upper bracket. And so we have just the right amount of gap here, so we can, the uppers always reside on the inside of our lower crash bars. So I'll get those set, and then I'll go ahead and just start my flatheads with two drops of Loctite. So with the two drops of Loctite, I'll get my assembly ready to go, and I'll get these fasteners started. So just gonna get that one started, get my next one started. So these aren't snugged up yet. I'm gonna go ahead and get my lower bolts in place and then jump to the other side. So, two Allens, washer each, and then we can now feed these through. And now, drop the Loctite on each. And then again, remember these are the serrated locking, so it's a bit of double thread locking engagement there. But I'm gonna leave these loose while I set up my other side. But this will help hold my upper crash bar. Okay, let's jump to the other side. I've got my gap there so I can slide my upper crash bar over and in, and then I'm gonna slide into my gap down here, and now I can get my fastener started. I've got my two flatheads. I'm gonna go ahead and get my thread locker in place. Get that guy started, that guy started, and I won't completely tighten these until I get my M6s started. So I'll go ahead and drop a washer on and a washer. We'll do our thread locker again. And then, so we feed our M6 bolts through, and then we'll grab our nuts. And again, these are the serrated locking nuts. And I'll get that guy on. And now my universal fronts are all started, but let's start and conclude by tightening down our flatheads first. The most delicate thread first. We're gonna get these completely tightened down. And you'll wanna do these also in a sequence similar to the way we did the exhaust flange, slowly bringing everything in. We get this great effect by doing these flatheads. It gives us this really nice seamless look once these are all tightened up. Again, these are stainless, so you don't want to over torque these. And now that these are tight, we can go drop down to tighten our universal brackets. Real straightforward here, guys. We're just going to go ahead and finalize and close up the brackets. Of course, always do your final tightening with the spanner, right? So there's a lot of friction and drag in your screw. You always want to do the final tightening with the actual nut on the nut side. It's a good universal tool tip across the board. So I'll go ahead and get this all driven up, and then I'll do my final torque. Repeat the same for your other side on your universal bracket, and now we'll move to reinforcement bars.